What's up, MTG players? It's Eclectics, and we're back on our Mythic run with draft number 5. We're stuck on plat 3 with 2 pips, though. Let's see where we end up today. Without further ado, it's drafting time. And we open with the ever-flowing well. New. Okay, yeah, it's Captain Storm. Man, I have no idea why Captain Storm is so very close to us. Like, the last 4 drafts have been... we've been opening Captain Storm pretty much every single draft. This draft, we're not passing red, so, well, the Dynatomaton, but it has a chance to wheel. This has a chance to wheel as well. This wheeling is fine. 2, and then 3, then 4. So what I want from this pack to wheel is Scampering Surveyor, Dynatomaton, Hidden Cataract, and the Everflowing Well is not bad, but yeah. Captain Storm first pick. Geological Appraiser. Let's go. So, an uncommon was picked here. I have no idea what was picked here. Look at this. This is ridiculous. There's 2 amazing cards here. And a common, either a common or an uncommon was picked. If it's not Zoetic Glyph, I have no idea what they took. There's white. Blue, black, red, and green. So it was a white, possibly a white common that was taken. Maybe like a Miner's Guide Wing? No idea. But yeah, it's a Geological Appraiser here. There's something for Anchorage, but Geological Appraiser goes with Captain Storm. This doesn't. And Geological Appraiser is just an awesome card. Alright, we'll take Wailing Pirates here. There's Whatley's Final Strike, but that's away from what we have. Wailing Pirates more than anything else, because, yeah, well, it's easy to pick up blue artifact commons. I was just thinking about this. There's so many blue artifact commons that should be able to build a deck with it. So the pick is Wailing Pirates here. This doesn't go with this, but it's just an awesome card by itself. And if you're in red, why not? Wailing Pirates, because we can play something on 3. Have Wailing Pirates go ahead and tap something. If black's being ignored, we shouldn't ignore black. Pick 4, join the dead. Alright, I'm in. What else can we use on this pack? Certainly not going for Ancestor's Aid. Panicked Altasaur. Join the Dead's pretty good. This is pick 4, so we can start getting the black cards. Nope. Still gonna go with red. Here's a perfectly great Plundering Pirate. There's Goblin Tomb Raider as well. Yep, gonna continue with the red train. Black green again. Here's Join the Dead and nope. So Panicked Altasaur was passed there, but that's a passable card, not particularly part of the Captain Storm deck. Riggs, actually the plug. Hit the mother load. Here's a Goblin Tomb Raider. There's a perfectly good Enterprise in Scallywag. Also a pirate, I think I'll take that because it produces a treasure token. Green's passed though. Poison Dart Frog Pick 6. No. Well, that has a higher upside. That's passable. As a 2. Yep. Because if green is available, then we should go ahead and take green. Here's Squaddle. There's also Explorer's Cache. There's Create a Sun's Creation. 4. Red is kind of open. Green is kind of open as well with this Squaddle pick. I think maybe, you know what? Let's explore with the Curator of Sun's Creation. Maybe we'll get more Itali's. Yeah, why not? Cartographer's Companion is great on 3. 4, Captain Storm, but I think we can get better blue cards. Like Self-Reflection. Or a completely usable River Herald Scout. Stupefaction is not a thing. Self-Reflection with Flashback though. What, at 6? Okay, we'll try it out. Alright, Watleys. They are passing. We're not getting blue. We're getting green. Huh. Alright. If green's up, red, green. Again. Like this. This is okay. Pick up more Itali's Favor and more dinos. Yeah. Poison Dart Frog on, yeah, Hoatlis. Huh. Okay, I'm in. Captain Storm not working out because not getting any great artifacts. But Plundering Pirate will enable this to be cast. So Walk with the Ancestors will be fine. Reeds. Huh, here we go. Cave Diver with Explore. We're not exploring. We're malametting. Yeah. Perfectly usable. We got a couple more picks, but okay. What was the other pick? What the heck? So that's not really a thing. We have options for So if we're gonna go blue, there's blue. Red was Plundering Pirate, but not really. Black. black with that. Alright. Plundering Pirate on 3. Maybe Oaken Siren still alive. No, this is fine. It'll draw us a card. And it's an artifact, so we can splash Captain Storm and be a green thingamajig. Nope. We'll take an Abrade. Cosmium Confluence more than an Abrade? Sure, okay. We're not gonna get back Abrade, but Cosmium Confluence. Alright, we'll pick up Gates then. Sure. Is that splashable? It is splashable. White. We got a lot of red cards. White. The Warden of the Inner Sky. There's a perfectly good artifact with Volatile Wander Glyph. Still definitely take Storm because we are getting artifacts. Artifact. It'd just be an aggressive green, red green though. Here's white. Black's also coming up, but the Plundering Pirate is pretty good. Alright, we'll take the Plundering Pirate. So Storm is kind of live still. Like this. Because we have a couple of Plundering Pirates. We're going to have to prioritize fixing, which means we need the 2-1 artifact dude. Alright, if white is available, I'm gonna go with white then. We didn't take Ixalan. That is a pretty good white card. White, green. Nope, let's take the gate. Gate for Cosmium Confluence. Yeah. Not seeing Itali's favor. This is discarding a number of cards, then draw at the beginning of your end step. If you descended this turn, put a boar counter. So we need to descend and. How do we descend? Huh. We can't. So, pirates still? Yeah. Got a couple of pirates. If we go like this, are we still okay? This is 9 cards. I think not. I think I'm okay with this. Dolly's favor, sure. Yep. Alright, we're gonna make it work. Gonna have to really prioritize some form of fixing. This is on 4 anyway. Red, green, maybe Captain Storm. Because we have One, two, three, four, five. Five. We can definitely just ignore that for red green. That means we need more stuff. Although the Wailing Pyre is just really good. If you can get blue mana. Which we can if we have Poison Dart Frog. Also, the other one. Not a thing. Maybe a thing. Buried treasure might make it. Huh, it's all black. Another one of those not so straightforward drafts. Green. Here's a staunch crewmate. Here's a Zoetic Glyph. I want to take Zoetic Glyph. Maybe a staunch crewmate will wheel. Artifacts. Five. More artifacts, but Zoetic Glyph should be fine. Because we have incidental artifacts. That's awesome. That can wheel, right? But I want this. Alright. So it's either Captain Storm. If we do Captain Storm... Couple of storms. Another Watley's Final Strike. I think not. Let's take the Yep, we got three colors. Okay. On four, it's this one. Three. Is it four? 3. I think I want that more than the other dino. If we remove So we have a lot of 4 drops. Dali's favor. This is kind of looking like a deck. See if we can improve it with... Oh, okay. Kin Caller. That was our original pack. So we didn't get the Staunch Crewmate back. The Kin Caller we got back. That might be a thing. I already have a Madam at sight. So buried treasure is not really awesome. Oh. We should have taken the other one. Yikers. Okay. We have to format this now because... We have a couple of Captain Storms, which I think is going to work better than green, but we took a lot of green. There's also this dude. Marauding Brinefang. Hidden Nursery and Hidden Volcano is on. Capybara. Not a thing. Song of Stupefaction. Alright, maybe we're not supposed to go blue. Well, the thing with blue is we have Zoetic Glyph. I'm gonna really have to check. So maybe what we can do is something like this. So this is what is causing big trouble. This one. As far as high top ends go, how many artifacts do we have? We only have 5 for Captain Storm, and they're crappy artifacts. One. Oh, they're not. So Zoetic Glyph isn't even awesome in the deck. So you have 1. Buried Treasure actually is fine. So 1. We didn't get the 1 to cast thingy. So Captain Storm is okay. Something like this. That's 19. If we don't put Captain Storm in, we have... Whoa. Oh, we have okay. 3.6. Have to take something out. 3.6. Descend. We didn't take any wake, so there's no way for us to get this back. But it is something for descend. Even the spider kind of sucks. I think I'm okay with this. Okay. So Captain Storm did not make it. Geological appraiser with daring discovery. Alright. This one I'm more confident on because we're at 3.6, 15.8. Nothing missable, although we have a couple of Captain Storms and there's a wedding glyph in the sideboard. I still think this is fine because we don't have a lot of artifacts to actually do anything with that. Yeah, we're fine. We'll try it out this way. Curator is there because Brass Tunnel Grinder is here. And if we discover with the curator, right? Descend with this. Okay. Okay. Let's try it out. We're more green than red. A little bit. We got a lot of reds as well. Red start, we got double green. Alright, let's try it out. I think we're going to be paired with mostly the guys in our draft. This is green. We don't have red. I think it's a mulligan. Okay. This, and we'll take the scythe out. I think it's the brass tunnel. Got more green. Okay. Green, please, for poison dart frog. And we can cast geological appraiser on 3. Come on. That's a braidable. Better that than the geological appraiser. I think. Oops. Sure. Can't pick it up. Sure. I think we'll let the mountain go along with the brass so we can draw 2. Hopefully one is a land. Also, since we descended, right? Yeah. It'll be good. So 2 then. think that was correct. Maybe you should have discarded one more. Yeah, come on. Go ahead. We'll descend again. So we'll stop playing lands and play out the volatile wonder glyph. That's a priority kill. I'm gonna priority kill that. Oh no. So we have 6. We throw everything on there. We descend again. And if there are 3 or more, okay. So we have 4, all right. Transform it. Cool. Now we're gonna be descending. Oh, we're gonna be, we want this, right? I think we're better off with this. Attack through that. We need more playables. He opened Quintorius. Cool. You can pick that up. That's totally fine. Playable, please. Yep. Cast a permanent. Oh, he gave up. What? Why did he give up? Okay, weird game. He gave up. We didn't have anything. We really didn't. The fact that we were able to get the Wander Glyph was quite amazing. Zoetic Glyph. How can we make use of you? There's like 1, 4, 5. 1, 4, 6. Is our red crappier than 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8? It's really not. It's really not. Alright. We're gonna continue. I still think Couple Captain Storms. We're fine, we're fine. Okay. We got 2, 3, 4. With removal. We didn't start though. We're assured now. So this could be any number of things. If you tap this again, I'm crashing in. So 4 mana, 3. Can't do that. 3. We descend. Nope, it's 4. So we either do that. Nope, we're not going to. He can go ahead and go stun that, sure. Okay. Kill that. And then 5, 6 can't. 3 can't. We can just go 5, but we're down 13. We can confluence next turn. Can we attack this turn? We can't attack this turn. Yep. Put this down. If we draw land. Belligerent. we draw land, do we have it? Okay. Yeah, we gotta trade here. This more than the Dinatomaton, right? This has trample though. Trample for what? Evasion more than... Because that is going to... Four. We can chomp. This is 6, save 4. Yeah, we can definitely. Do we have it? We have pocket nines now. Okay, still wants to attack with the thing, that's fine. Okay. Dead then. Daring discovery. Does this kill? If he flips something. This is 9. He has to block 1. He can't block this 9. He blocks this 3. 1. 1 plus 6. Should be dead, right? If he has brackish, though, we're screwed. This is 7, 9. He did not play it safe. I don't know. He could have had brackish. Brackish is the only thing that he could have had. Why did he attack though? What did he have? Could still do what exactly? Block, block, but he had what? Didn't have enough. He was hoping I didn't have anything or we didn't have enough, but any of the two cards that we had in hand was enough. Either Cosmic Confluence or actually even more, because we would have made the Cosmic Confluence. Okay, I'll go first, but please draw some action. Our first one is a 3-drop. Okay. Anything good? That's fine. Power on board. Deadweight. Destroy target enchantment. So I can choose this. And then 2, 3, destroy target. No, it's not good. If he double blocks, if he blocks this, we can still get him, yeah. Not draw land though. It's kind of bad. Now there are a couple of 5/4s. best bet. I can kill that one. Down to one. Ward 2, we can still pay for it. Well, no, if he can play one more thing. Just need a land, right? If we... He has to block with both. Can keep one, right? Seven, five, no attacks. Now he's gonna craft one, which we are okay with. Six, five, yep, he's gonna craft it. This is what exactly? Four. Then this will come down. Five. one card in hand. Can't craft it. Damn, what was it? Two cards in hand. Alright, we're attacking. Whatever happens. Three. We got removal. We got two. But yeah, we're attacking. Yeah, no blocks. All right, cool. We win. Daring discovery worked that time. Or, well, see, on this battlefield, we could just remove one and we'll still win. Yep. Or four. We can go Dynatomaton. This crash and we still win because he needs five blockers. Two, one, two, three. Yep. We had quite a bit. We had two. Well, with the Daring Discovery, three. Three ways out. We were short on mana on that game, though. Like, if we drew more mana, a bit more mana early on, we would have been able to kill him faster, I guess. We have three. We have removal for days. Two drop, please. Two drop, two drop, two drop, two drop, two drop, two drop, two drop. Two drop. Five drop instead. So, that's not a great deal for us. That is a lot of stuff. Can't block. Not yet. Great news, but so he can have all sorts of things. Cosmo Blast is going to prevent us from doing the stuff that we need to. The Malamith site, though, should take care of this. Because it's, okay. He will just be able to kill it. So the thing about this is that this is a veteran thing, right? We're at 12. Veteran will go ahead and take care. Okay. We are blocking. Caparotti. The next turn, if we somehow survive, yep. Hopefully this does not screw us up. All right, cool. We're able to do this. What could he have? He could descend, he could take out this, right? If we attack right now, 9, he'll take get us back with 3, 4, but this is a lot of damage. Another cloud guard. Assuming we don't die, we got it. Definitely attacking. Oh crap, we're dead. He got the, yeah. Unfortunate. Yeah. Yeah, pretty good. Pretty good match. Yeah, he just had the great draws. Our opponent just had great draws. Three Ultek Cloud Guards. Yikes. Three Ultek Cloud Guards. Remove a couple. Very, very aggressive Boros deck. No, we're not keeping this. Are we? It's a do nothing deck. We have removal though. Four. Curse again because we. No, I don't keep it. Come on, deck. Draw into what we need. That's actually really good if we can get the Dynatomaton. We have a couple of Dynatomatons. Okay. We have Brazen Blade Master. We're down one. A couple of removals. Attacking anytime soon. Here we go again though. We have, if we can get the Dynatomaton, we're still not attacking. Aerial Assault. Ooh. He's attacking for everything. It's a lot of damage. And now he's got that. I'm down nine. Next turn. So yeah, keeping a whole lot of nothings is really bad. Plus we drew our spells. We can only block one. Right now we can kill this. And then are we going this? Damage. If we resolve damage now, this is what? Eight. Doesn't kill us, but we'll be down one. Doesn't matter. It's still dying. So we have to use Whatley Strike to get rid of that and survive. And we're dead again. Keep keeping it was so bad. What did he take out the map? Doesn't matter because we are dead. Didn't draw anything. Versus an aggressive deck. We lost to aggressive decks. Yeah, because we don't have any of our starters. Our deck basically starts on 3. But we do have 2 drops. If we don't have 2 drops or 3 drops. No, we did have a 3 drop. We just didn't have a follow-up to the 3 drop. Yeah, we really didn't have a follow-up to the 3 drop. Our life starts at 4. Come on, deck. Fight. Fight for your life. You got stuff in you. Fight for it. 3. We had 3-0, and then we started. We got a couple of losses because of very, very aggressive starts. If we can actually stave off those aggressive starts, 100% sure we can survive the longer game. Yeah, this is fine. And we started this time, which is really, really good. Matter. Do we keep this? We can't. We don't. We won't have a chance to get another land. Does it matter? Oh, Itali's favor is going to. I think, yeah. He has joined the dead. Yeah, we're screwed. Ooh, he took it out. Are we... Is a land better than this? We have to continue with the land draws, right? No. This, okay, sure, fine. Man, not like that. We took out a land, we drew a land. What the hell? Oh, he's looking for lands. 3 and 3, no blocks. Because he wants to strike for lands, right? Do not draw and this is even better than huh? What? This is Island Swamp. Oh, he has the okay. Come in. Freaking gutter. Crap. Damn it. That was really so dumb. Like, anyway, we won not because of our great gameplay, but because of him not drawing any lands. God damn it, man. Dead weight on... He had the fungal thing. So even if he fungals that thing back, it doesn't matter. He'll be very behind on board. Keepable. Not gonna win with that start. That's an awesome start. Please draw land. Deck, come on. Show me what you got. I need your stuff. Okay, he's gonna take the volatile wander glyph. If I do the thing, I can do 5-4. I can do 4. Deadweight might screw us up, but so I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can do this. I can scythe this so he can't catch up, right? But I don't want him to descend on my turn. Wait, so do we, is it a, if he descends on his turn, it's not great, right? I can't even dot 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I can't. I have to double now, right? Nope. We wait. Okay. Attack because of the death caps. It's so bad. Yeah, we're trading now. We can't attack through this. What did we actually... No, it's the other artifact. Okay, 4. We can't attack through the marionettes. Dolly's favor. What else do we have? Geological appraiser. We've never actually... What else do we have? A Huatlis. Thank you. Join the dead. No, you'll be able to craft that. We're dead. Yes, Jamil. Change. We just didn't get very far. That didn't help. No caves. No anything. Yep. Flyers going all the way. Our answers, well, we had Watleys, but we needed to kill something. Yeah, the marionettes weren't letting us do anything. Plus, he had a couple of Zoetic Glyphs. Yep. And then Flood. 9 versus 7. And he was drawing more than us. Yeah. Well, another mediocre deck with oh, we got to plat 2. Ooh. Oh yeah, because we had a streak. We had a three game streak. That's why we were able to go to 2. Well, that's kind of an accomplishment. We got to 4, so again, not extremely bad, but again, the draws were kind of horrendous, especially towards the end. Sidetracked with Captain Storm not working out. First pick Captain Storm, but I said it was easy to get the artifacts, but we didn't get artifacts. Got some artifacts in the end, but yeah, I didn't really see a lot of blue artifacts. Saw a lot of green. A lot of green stuff. Cosmium Confluence, we were able to use like one time. Geological Appraiser, 7 games. Never showed up. Italy's showed up more. This Brassus Tunnel Grinder showed up more. Poison Dart Frog showed up once, I guess. Yeah, showed up once, but we had to sacrifice it to Tithing Blade, I think. So, yeah, Watley's was really, really good. Malman Sight was also fine, but if this was Idol of the Deep King, it would have actually been better. Curator of Sun's Creation, meh. Maybe we were better off with With red, I really don't think so. So our green, if we don't do green, say we don't do green, it's red, blue. We don't have much removal. We'll have a couple of storms. We'll have this. I guess this you can call removal. And that's it. We lacked quite a bit. Yeah, we lacked quite a lot, actually. 14-5, yeah, so it looked like this. That's why we couldn't hack it. 20, maybe this, maybe self-reflection, target creature I control, so waylaying pirates maybe it would have looked like something like this. And this is 3.7, so yo, extremely huge. Twenty-three, so something like this. Yeah, it'll have to be something like this. Does not look great. It's not look enticing at all. Although number of artifacts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 artifacts, yeah? 6. 8 because we're counting Plundering Pirate to have a couple of artifacts with it. Yeah, I don't think it'll jive very well. We had a chance to pick up like the Oaken Siren with the Captain Storm. Maybe we should have just stayed the course. I don't know. This is how it turned out. Curator of Sunspiration without a lot of discovers. But what we were trying to do is we were trying to have Curator of Sun's Creation with the Brass's Tunnel Grinder. But then that means that the deck isn't fast. So it defeats the purpose of the deck. Yipers, okay. Buried Treasure over Daring Discovery, maybe. Yeah, even on the last game, the only thing we... anyway. Alright, on to the next one. Yeah. I got you. Discard. We did get the plat too, which is awesome. But yeah. Let's claim it. Lost 100 gems. Thanks for watching. If you made it this far, why don't you smash that like button? Please consider subscribing and check out my other vids. See you on the next one.